What's up, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. Sorry for not uploading regularly lately. I apologize, you guys. Been super busy, but I'm trying to get back into that. So like always, let me know in the comments more things or topics you want me to cover. Today, I come to you with a beauty shoot video. I don't think I've uploaded many of those before. Before I get into it, remember to like, follow, subscribe, and check out your boy's work on Instagram, @_youngshot. All right, let's get right into it. For beauty shoots, a lot of the time, I'll use, obviously, the beauty dish. It gives a nice, strong lighting effect. I like it when it's like bold lighting, not super soft, which I feel like is very popular. I prefer kind of going with harsher lighting. Or a lot of times I'll use like a big Octobox, but this time I wanted to experiment a bit with some clamshell lighting. And sometimes I'll use, a lot of times I'll use my reflector underneath, but this time I wanted to try with shooting with both of these lights, the Octobox on top and the beauty dish at the bottom, pointed in a way where it could fill in a bit from the bottom in a nice way and get some catch light going on. But then the upper light as well, lighting her in a lovely way, which was a nice middle ground between soft and ultra harsh. Third light we have facing the wall. It's powered down pretty much all the way, but the purpose of this light is to give some, to illuminate the backdrop a bit. But like I said, I don't like it super white in this scenario. When I'm shooting editorial stuff, I like a little bit off-white. So it's really just pushed all the way down. And the model is a bit far off the backdrop to avoid shadows or stuff like that. And to, again, not illuminate it as much with our key lighting. Started out as well, some nice classic, simple, you know, nice lighting. It quickly became a little bit repetitive, you know, which is, I feel like, is a common thing in studio sometimes. So I ordered on Amazon some colored paper, some LED paper, whatever it's called, I forgot. But if you want it, I'll link it below. And I put it around the light to give a bit of a blue effect, you know. And so we did it with the light behind her head, which may seem odd, but that way you can kind of wrap around her in a nice way. And, you know, it might take a little bit of experimentation, but it could look cool in the right setting. I just did to try it out. It might not be the best example where to test it out. In a different situation, I think it could look cooler. But nonetheless, it's a nice image that came out of it. You gotta be careful when using these, when using these gels though, because especially the cheaper ones, it may burn through and you don't want a fire opening up, you know. I have a whole fire extinguisher, you know, next to me just in case. Now, not like right next to me when I'm doing these, but in my premises, and I check it periodically to make sure it's not burning. I'm the type of guy though that every time I do a shoot, I'm like, damn, like, I should have done that, I should have done this. Could have done that better, I should have tried that. But I mean, I think, if anything, just remember those and write them down or whatever, and there's always gonna be many more shoots, you know? So, it's not a big deal. And it'll give you more to think about next time around, for sure. Going into it with Ravianchi's first look, it was lovely, it was simple, it was clean. But the hair was throwing me off a little bit. So a quick, easy fix for situations like this sometimes is in the right situation, though obviously not every single time, but I was like, oh, just some nice wet hair, kind of like, you know, run your fingers through the back of it, like kind of pressed on the head, could look really like, really chic, you know? And in this case, I was right. Because it really did look chic when she came back, and it was really photographing well and catching like a nice shimmer from the light. since I was saying, like, sometimes the studio stuff gets repetitive and a little bit, you know, bland, I wanted to take some of these more simple photos and composite them and try to do something a little bit more exciting to up it up, like I said. So I tried this in some of these photographs and I think it came out quite well. Beauty photography and portraiture in general is actually quite enjoyable for me. And having my own studio now, I really want to get back into it. It's something that doesn't require a crazy amount of space, right? Because a lot of it's like contained within a certain area. And it's just, I think, you know, phases are very strong and they tell a story. And another plus is that beauty photography actually pays really well. So I'm hoping to start doing more of these and trying out more things like scrims and such. Although I said I prefer harsher lighting, it would be nice to start trying things like that just to try. But again, thank you guys for watching the video. Let me know what you thought about the images. Leave a comment below and catch you next time. Thanks for watching again.